Displacement can turn any flat surface into a very detailed structure. In this video, I'm going to show you how does that happen exactly. To make it more fun, I'll be using a surreal example, but it applies to much more than just those glass jars. Speaking of which, I'm going to use V-Ray Ready 3D glass jar model, which can be found at modellab.co. Just to remind you, ModelLab is a platform with high-quality SketchUp models, lots of them are free. I'm going to log in and download that SKP file, unzip it and open with SketchUp. I'm also changing the style for something more visible for you guys before we move on. Okay, first of all, the jar is empty, so we need to come up with a volume inside. Let's copy the glass part and cut the top. Now delete the outer shelf and then offset it equally with joint push-pull plugin. It should be around 3 mm. Joint push-pull lets you push or pull several surfaces at once. You can find the source of this plugin in the description of the video below. And if you don't know how plugins work, see the other video of ours entitled How to install SketchUp extensions and where to find them. There are still some geometry that I don't need, so delete it. After that, I'm going to change the glass material to an opaque default material. I'm painting both front and back faces. I can see it needs reversing. The white color should be visible from the outside, just like it is right now. Alright, the top needs to follow the same quad face logic as the rest of the model. The cheat sheet is on the bottom. It should look like this, so you either copy it or build it from the scratch. In the end, it should look like this. Pretty much evenly divided faces, ready to be textured. So, textures. I'm going to use cgbookcase.com, a platform with free photorealistic textures. Dorian is doing a really good job with this one, so consider supporting him on Patreon or at least follow his social media, just like I do. Back on tracks. I'm searching for some nice surreal PBR texture, which I know can be found on page number 5. Yep, there it is, along other great sits and pops. I'm going to use all of them, but let's start with Cornflakes 01. As you can see, besides the regular base color map, there are also ambient occlusion, height, normal and roughness maps as well. All of those are necessary to create good looking material. That's why I'm downloading them all, one by one. In SketchUp, I'm creating a new material called ModelLab Cornflakes. I'm going to use the base color texture I downloaded from CG Bookcase for the default bitmap. Now, let's add that material to the volume inside. We have to paint 3 slots in order for displacement to work correctly. First, front faces, then back faces, and lastly, the whole group. I'm just making sure that the cornflakes material is in all of those 3 areas. Yes, it is, but the texture looks horribly shattered. A V-Ray mapping tool seen here could help you with that. You can choose either a sphere or triplanar projection to make it look a little bit better. There still are some seams visible, but that's just the way it is. I made it look even better, but with some advanced UV techniques, which could be a subject for another tutorial. Forget about mapping for now and move on to that displacement thing. If I hit render, the surface is still as flat as the volume itself. We have to go to V-Ray materials to make it look more convincing. I'm looking for ModelLab Cornflakes material on the list. There it is. I've created it in SketchUp and it automatically got V-Ray attributes. It can be reflection, refraction, bump or displacement, among many others. Let's turn the displacement on by clicking on this switch. Great, but does that change anything? Not yet. We need to put a height map in this slot. How do I know which one is a height map? It has height in the title, but also it should be black and white. In V-Ray language, black means 0% and white means 100%. Think of it as of a height graph where the lowest areas are black and the tallest are white. That's how displacement parameter interprets this image. Let's see if there is any change in the visualization. Of course there is. If you have done everything correct, it should look sort of like this. The value of 1 is extreme, so I'll go with 0.2. Now it's more similar to the Cyril that I know. There are just those disturbing breaks on the seams. It can be simply fixed by thinking keep continuity. The seam can still be visible, but it's not as obvious as it was before. There are no breaks. Okay, let's move the cornflakes back to the jar and hit render again. Now, it seems like the volume is too big for that container. If you look closely, you can see that some of the tallest parts of the texture pierce through the glass. We could lower the displacement amount, but I like it that way. I want the map to shift inside. It's actually very simple to do. Just slide down the shift parameter. Value of 0.15 should be enough. Yes, that's how the displacement works in general. I've added the rest of the maps to reflection and bump filter, and that's the final result. It surely does look convincing, right? You can practice with them other textures from cgbookcase.com. I've done sunflower seeds, raisins, pumpkin seeds, oat pops, and mixed seeds. I've also uploaded the model with total 6 different content glass jars, so you could download it for free and use it in your kitchen design. The link is in the video description below. Make sure you also visit modelab.co, where you will find high-quality SketchUp models ready to use in V-Ray. Some of them, like those bath towels, are using displacement map to imitate weave structure better. So, that's all for now. Thank you guys for watching. Consider subscribing to ModelUp channel, where you will find more tips from the SketchUp professionals. See you soon!